Good morning, everybody. The study we are going to present is a clinical research on how well point-of-care tests perform in a real-life setting. They are promising tools to improve large-scale screening, especially among hard-to-reach populations, such as men who have sex with men in different settings. As researchers and clinicians involved in an HIV-STI screening program, we wanted to investigate the real performance of the rapid diagnostic tools recently developed and introduced in the market. In order to evaluate their performance in an homogeneous and high-risk population, we performed our evaluation exercise among men who have sex with men living in Verona. Indeed, MSM are considered, even in the most recent WHO and ECDC reports, one of the most at-risk populations, as they accounted for the 42% of the new HIV diagnosis and for 63% of new cases of syphilis in Europe during 2014.
In the study, we enrolled 289 asymptomatic MSM. We evaluated two POCTs, the BioLine Syphilis 3.0 and the CanBio Syphilis Screen and Confirm Assay, on both serum and fingerprint blood. The results of the POCTs were compared with those of the syphilis serological laboratory gold standard tests, such as TPPA and RPR. The rapid test results were read by naked eye by two independent readers, and the concordance between readers was assessed. The performance on both specimens resulted lower than expected when compared to that reported in the literature and in the technical specifications provided by the manufacturers. This is particularly evident when finger prick blood samples were tested. As you may see, whilst the specificities of both POCTs were above 99% on both serum and finger prick blood, the sensitivity values varied considerably. Indeed, the sensitivity of the BioLine test was lower on finger prick blood when compared to that on serum. In contrast, the CanBio test exhibited similar sensitivity values for both specimens. Considering the titration provided by the laboratory tests, it seems that for TPPA values higher than 1280 and RPR values higher than or equal to 1:8, the misclassification rate for the two POCTs was extremely low, both on serum and blood. In terms of concordance, we found a very high agreement between the readers for both POCTs.
In conclusion, the performance of the two point-of-care tests evaluated proved to be inferior to those of the gold standard laboratory tests. However, when used strategically in settings where venipuncture is not safe or impossible to perform, or when the population is very mobile or for legal reasons not entitled to receive the standard medical assistance, as illegal migrants, sex workers, drug users, and so forth, these point-of-care tests can be extremely useful in identifying syphilis cases requiring medical assistance and treatment. The results of our study led us to consider the use of syphilis point-of-care tests as potential alternative to laboratory methods to improve screening practice, particularly outside the hospital setting. However, additional evaluations are certainly needed to further assess the potential replacement of standard tests with the point-of-care test approach in different scenarios, and the potential impact of such a shift.